Ultimate is the goal. My name is Umar Yusuf and I appear as co-counsel on behalf of respondent senior officer. Counsel will be addressing your excellencies on the third count of this case, which is that if, even if the advertisement was an offer, it was successfully revoked. May I proceed the court?
Yes.
Counsel will address the first issue of the third count in the next few minutes. And that is that the counsel submits that revocation was effective on the assumption that the advertisement comprised an offer. In contract law, an offer which was made can be revoked before the offeree accepts it, as in the case Bain versus Van Johansson, where the defendant wrote a letter on October 1st to the plaintiff offering a sale of 1,000 boxes of tin plates. The defendant was based on Cardiff and the plaintiff was based in New York, and the letters took around 10 to 11 days to be delivered. The plaintiff received this letter on October 11th and accepted it on the same day by telegram, as well as by letter on October 15th. However, on October 8th, the defendant sent a letter to the plaintiff which withdrew their offer, and this arrived with the plaintiff on October 20th. The plaintiff's claim for damages for the non-delivery of the tin plates. So in this case, the counsel submits that in unilateral cases, revocation can be made as long as the revocation is communicated in the same manner as how it was offered.
Did you convey it in the same mode?
Yeah, that's what the counsel submits. In Chue versus US, the United States used newspapers to publicize a reward for the arrest of an accomplice on the murder of President Lincoln. The offer was later revoked in the same manner through a newspaper. The concern was given by the court of law to communicate the revocation in the same manner was to try to reach out to the same audience that read the newspaper, newspaper's unilateral offer. It is worthy to take note that there is no legal obligation or legal duty to satisfy an acceptor who does not know of the revocation. However, in this case, Ms. Butina, through the revocation wasn't made, though the revocation wasn't made in the same manner, it was made through means of similar publicity with even better reach to the acceptors, as there is reasonable belief that all acceptors will receive the revocation as they await to accept the previous offer on Senior Beauty Salon's Facebook page. The most important factor to be taken into consideration that has to be addressed is that revocation done by Senior Beauty Salon, whether an offer can be revoked once a continuing acceptance has already commenced.
Yeah, now let me stop you there. Your advertisement, assuming that it was an offer,
yes.
Okay, if we assume that it's an offer, your advertisement says you have to accept by midnight. You revoked at 12:01. That was after the time that was set by you. So, if the appellant had uploaded it by 12, will your revocation be valid?
The counsel believes that this, the counsel will address this issue on the second count, on the second issue of this third count, because the counsel believes that this was not an offer. This case.
Yeah, I said, counsel, I used the word assume.
Assuming.
So everything is assumed. I assume that it was an offer, and then I assume that she uploaded it by 12 midnight. Then your revocation, which was made at 12:01, will it be valid or not?
The revocation which was made at
12:01. You revoked it at 12:01, right?
Yes.
So will it be valid at that, in those circumstances, assuming it happened that way? In that case, will your revocation be valid or not?
The counsel believes that it will be valid, but however, it
doesn't
apply to.
Why would it be valid?
It would be valid because. It was passed on after the time for acceptance has.
Yeah, that was in this case, counsel. I said, assuming she uploaded it by 12. If she uploaded it by 12, you revoking it at 12:01, will it be valid or not?
It will be invalid. The counsel believes that it is invalid. May the counsel proceed?
Yes.
The most important question to be addressed as a part of the revocation done by Senior Beauty Salon is whether an offer can be revoked once a continuing acceptance has already commenced. Ms. Butina, according to the statement of facts, started doing her acceptance And the offer was revoked before she was done with her acceptance. In Errington versus Errington, where the court decided that there is an implied promise not to revoke once a performance has already commenced. However, the acceptance of the unilateral offer was communicated to the offerer in Errington versus Errington, whereas in Butina's case, it was not done. The communication of the revocation, the communication of the acceptance was not done.
But counsel, your co-counsel said that it's a bilateral contract, it's a unilateral contract, therefore is communication of acceptance necessary in a unilateral contract?
The counsel will address that further.
Okay. Now your presentation is on the assumption that it was accepted, right? Is your argument now that you're making, is it on the assumption that it was accepted, however the revocation is valid, right?
The opinion of the existence of this implied promise is criticized in the case Luxor Eastbourne versus Cooper, where the vendor company had instructed agents to sell properties on its behalf and had agreed to pay a commission on completion of the sale. However, the sale was agreed with a prospective purchaser being introduced to the agents. Thereafter, before the sale was completed, the vendor company withdrew from the sale because of an objection from one of its directors. Lord Russell, in this case, he said, I quote, "In my opinion, there is no necessity in these contracts for any implication of that nature." Furthermore, acceptance, according to many legal experts, in unilateral contracts, especially reward-related ones, acceptance takes place upon completion of the acceptance. Therefore, non-completion means no acceptance whatsoever of the offer, which allows the offerer to revoke, as in Routledge versus Grant, in which the defendant contacted the claimant in writing offering to purchase the lease of the claimant's house. The offer stated that it would remain open for the claimant for a period of